Hi, and welcome to Talking Tech. I'm your host, Alejandro Hoyos, and today we're here at Computex 2025, and we have Shin with us, who's going to tell us about this amazing product that we're launching. Yeah, actually, we're launching it here today. Hey, yeah. Shin, how's it going?
Hi, Alex. Good to be talking to you again.
Thank you. Good to have you here. So I heard that there's this new thing coming out that is, I think it's called Battlematrix. Can you tell us a little bit more about it?
Well, we have this new internal code name called Battlematrix, which makes up our new inference workstation line that is comprised of software and hardware.
That's great. But I think inference workstation, it's something new. I haven't heard that before. Can you tell us a little bit more about it?
So traditionally, we've had graphics workstations for professionals doing architecture and design. Inference workstations is really an application where you need a lot of bandwidth and ability to scale up your GPU memory to serve very large AI models. And these AI models solve real engineering problems automatically through an agentic workflow, like coding or PCB design, and professionals use them to really accelerate their workflow and productivity.
Okay, that's great. I think you have a demo here, but can you tell us a little bit about it? Because I think it's involved with coding.
Yeah, one of our awesome demos here is a real engineering use case that we've used inside of Intel, where we're debugging a software decode on Lunar Lake. What would have taken days of engineering work looking through tens of thousands of lines of code just takes hours with this agentic workflow, where the agents automatically do your triage, your debug, and write your code, and even test it for you, so that at the end of the day, even junior engineers can do the work of more experienced engineers.
So, Qi, I see we have a lot of things here. Why don't you tell us a little bit more what it is?
Yeah, this is actually a pretty simple demo. This is what a laptop an engineer might use. This is the system that they would be debugging, and this is the Project Battlematrix system on which the AI that helps them debug would be running.
That is great. All right, so we're debugging. What type of code are we debugging here?
Yeah, so this is an example of a video playback error, and it's a real thing that we went and fixed. So you can see what corruption looks like. And what the system is doing is going to analyze all the code that was written to do this video playback and triaging the debug log, debugging it, fixing the code, designing new code, writing it, and then testing it all automatically. So this saves a ton of engineering time. In something like a design agent, the way it saves engineering time is you have a lot of different specs that you have to look through, like an architecture B spec, software documentation. Comparing all these specs takes a lot of engineering time. And what you want is a helper for you to look through all this documentation so engineers can be more productive in designing new and cool things for Intel and not looking through and comparing documentation.
No, this is great. I mean, I can see how it saves a lot of time for engineers, especially on the design side, and also would have saved me a lot of trouble and headaches back when I was in college debugging my own code. But this is great. This is a great show of what this new technology can do and also what the new B60 can do for us. So this is amazing, and thanks for sharing this with us. So Battlematrix, and we have this whole new definition of inference workstation. What are the ingredients of that?
So we have a bunch of what we call the new Arc Pro B60 cards, which are pro cards that can do 24 gigs of memory with 456 gigabytes of memory bandwidth. And by putting multiple ones of these together, you can run models up to 192 gigabytes in size, which is quite big. And that allows you to have the enough intelligence to do real world work. Battlematrix is unique in that we're allowing multiple different hardware vendors to serve very different use cases. Combined with system vendors and software vendors, we're releasing a full hardware and software solution. In the software solution, we're testing a full software stack from all the way from the driver up to the VLM serving layer, providing an easy to deploy, easy to update solution for enterprises, small and medium businesses around the world.
This is pretty impressive, because I think this is the first time that we see Intel providing a full solution from when it comes from hardware to software stack, so that the end user can actually just be like a turnkey solution for them completely. And that is a very big work that we have to do in order to do that.
Yeah, absolutely. It's going to require a lot of collaboration from industry partners. Intel is all about partnerships, and this is one of the most complicated partnership solutions that we're going to deliver.
No, that's amazing. So I see a lot of cards. I think there's the cards, right? Can we take a look at one or two of them?
Sure. What I have here is two cards. One is a actively cooled card from Sparkle, and the other one is a passively cooled card from our partner, Gunnir. And this exemplifies what we're trying to do. AI is a field that is growing so quickly, and there are so many different use cases. By allowing our partners to design very different form factors for very different use cases, we're really looking to be able to scale out the ability to serve many different AI use cases across the globe.
That's great. I think I was looking at this one earlier, and we were actually talking, and I don't see an active heatsink in here. This is all passive, right?
Right. It's passive. The air needs to be generated by the server chassis itself. That's why we have a bunch of different system integration partners delivering different form factor solutions.
That's great. So you can have this one for a server rack mount, and also if you need a regular workstation, you have this one also with an active heat.
That's right.
That's awesome. Qi, thank you so much. Appreciate it. This has been great.
Thank you, Alex.
Thank you for having us.
Yeah, absolutely.